Okay, guys, so today we're talking about everybody's favorite part of camping, and that is the campfire itself. So I've got everything set up here. We're going to go do our intro, and we'll come right back. All right, guys, so like I said in the cold open there, this one's going to be on campfires, how to build them, some things like that. Couple little house cleaning things before we kick it off though. You guys are doing an excellent job of sharing the videos, subscribing, liking, commenting, stuff like that, telling us things that you do like and things that you don't like. So that really helps us to narrow things down and get it to a point to where we can really funnel it to what you guys are interested in. So continue to do that. We're getting close to 1,000 people. Once we hit 1,000 subscribers, I think we're going to do another giveaway. Haven't quite decided what that's going to be yet, but, you know, just if you're in the group, you can throw it out in the group or something that you might like. But like I said, once we hit 1,000, we're definitely going to do a giveaway. So keep putting the word out there. Other than that, that's really all I have on the house cleaning side of things. So we'll go ahead and get right into it. So for before we start our campfire, there's a couple of things that we want to consider, a couple of little safety items. We want to make sure that our campfire is going to be a safe distance away from our tent or our camper or wherever you know, we're sleeping, for one thing. We want to make sure it's far enough away from where we store our firewood, and we don't want it to be near any like dry grass or bushes, anything like that, really anything that's going to catch on fire. As a general rule, you want about 6 feet, just to make sure that you don't have any ash that flies off or anything like that that might spark something off. Paradise Fire, wildfire in California was actually started by a campfire, so don't be that guy. I've said it once, I've said it 100 times, don't be that guy. Another thing, you want to have something to extinguish the fire with if it does happen to get out of control, because sometimes you can do everything right and something still goes wrong. You know, have a fire extinguisher handy. If you're tent camping, you don't have a fire extinguisher, you know, have a bucket of water, just something that you can put it out with. Even, you know, an old blanket, and, you know, worst case scenario, smother the fire out. But moving on from safety, I'm not going to beat that up too badly. We need a few things to get our fire going and get it off quick and without too much aggravation. I see people at campsites a lot that try and start fires and they get aggravated and they just can't do it. And really, guys, it's not that hard. I really enjoy it. It's kind of like a lost art, almost a lost skill that's kind of died with, you know, evolution of man, really. We have electric stoves and ranges and things like that, even gas-fired ranges. We are so accustomed to just going into the house and turning a knob and being able to cook something, or, you know, going over to the thermostat, pushing a couple of buttons and making heat. So for me, starting a fire is kind of fun. It's like a throwback almost. So you need a couple of different types of wood. You need kindling, tinder, and your fuel wood. And I think I got kindling and tinder backwards. I think it's tinder and then kindling, but anyway, we're not going to get bogged down too much in semantics on this one. So for your tinder, you want nice small branches, things like that, things that you can easily find walking around, work well. Pine needles work really well. Just something that's going to light easily and burn long enough to get your kindling, your larger wood, to actually start to burn. So what I did is I've got a couple of sticks here and I've broken them up really small. They're about, say, about 2-3 inches in length. And then I actually took some of those sticks and made them a little bit bigger, something a little more for to catch once this gets going. For kindling, I actually take the crates that we get at work and just cut them up. Honestly, guys, old lumber, like lumber scraps and things like that, work excellent for kindling. It lights quickly, it burns hot, good stuff. And then for your fuel wood, we've got a couple of pieces of wood that I've cut and split at the house, and brought with us here. So we've got all of our wood that we need that we're gonna use. We have to decide how we're going to set our campfire up. Now there's three main ways that you can do it. There's the teepee method, which is essentially just what you think it sounds like. It's like making a teepee. It's not really one of my favorite ones. It's not one that we're going to be doing today. It does have the advantage of it lights quickly, and it burns for a decent amount of time. I'm not particularly a fan of it, but that's just me. It's sort of like trucks or shoes or anything else. Everybody's got their preference. The next is like the log cabin style, which also has the advantage of lighting very quickly. It's good to cook over, and it also burns down very quickly. We'll be using that today. And then there is the pyramid or the upside down fire, which is actually what I use in my wood burning stove at home. And that one, what you do is you would put all of your wood, you put all your fuel wood at the bottom, and then you would put your kindling and then your tinder, and then you light it from the top and it would burn down. And I know there's somebody out there right now that is going, "Oh, you're an idiot. Fire burns up, it doesn't burn down." Well, fire also follows its fuel source too, so it's going to naturally burn down following the fuel down to the bottom of the fire, lighting the fuel wood on fire. This fire lasts forever, guys. I can burn 3, 4, 5 hours in my wood stove and not have to add wood to it. So I'm not really looking to have a fire last that long today because it's like 85 degrees out. But like I said, if you are trying to have a fire that burns all night long with very little maintenance, the pyramid or upside down, and then if you just want a fast fire, a fire that's going to burn light quickly and burn down fast so that you can cook over it like what we're going to be doing, either the teepee or the log cabin. So we've decided, we've got our wood together, we've decided what we're going to do. We need just a couple of things to make this happen. One tool always to keep around is a little camp axe. It's good to have it nearby in case you've got to split a piece of kindling to make it a little smaller, you know, cut a branch out of a tree. That was one other thing I was going to say on safety. When you're at your campsite, be aware of things like burn bans, and also be aware of the rules of having campfires at your campsite. Some places don't allow you to bring in your own camp firewood, and some places also don't allow you to really scavenge for wood or anything like that. So that's something good to check on before you show up. Let you know if you gotta bring fire starters and things like that with you. But yes, good to have a camp axe with you. A pair of gloves is also handy, some nice leather gloves, because you know you don't want to have to reach into the fire to have to move something and not have gloves on. And then for starting the fire, you can either use a lighter. These grill lighters or candle lighters work really well. Or you can use a flint and a steel, and these work really well too. One other thing that I have is I have actually made a little fire kit for myself, and it actually fits into a little Altoids tin. And what I've got in here, pull everything out so you can see it. These are homemade fire starters. They're cotton balls soaked in petroleum jelly or Vaseline. These work really well for starting stuff. I can light off my entire wood stove with just one cotton ball. There's a lighter in here, so I always have a lighter. Another thing that works really well, if I can get it out, is birthday candles. You can actually just kind of stick it, wedge it in between two pieces of wood, light the wick, and it'll burn down. And another thing I have in here is just strike anywhere matches. Put them in a little Ziploc bag here so that they stay nice and dry for me. So we're gonna get set up and we'll see if I can light off a fire. Okay guys, so I got the fire built, or not built, but I've got it set up ready to light. And what I've done is I've got my fuel logs down in the bottom. I've got two of them facing this way, and then on top of those I put two perpendicular. And then in the center of this box that I've made essentially is all my kindling and my tinder and all that stuff. And I've got one of the cotton balls that is soaked in Vaseline is sitting right about here. I'm sure you probably can't see it, but that's what we're gonna light. And then this is kind of like, this is the log cabin style, but it's sort of a hybrid between this and the upside down fire. So we'll light it off and hopefully in a couple minutes we'll have a nice good fire going. And I'm going to use the lighter. I'm going to cheat because I've got my fire starter so deep. We'll come back in a couple minutes. Okay guys, so like you can see, it's not hard. It's a lot like painting. A little bit of prep at the beginning goes a long way at the end. You know, this has been going for about 3 minutes now. Our fuel wood is starting to light off. So like I said, it's a good fire to get up and going really quickly. It'll burn down nice and fast for you so you can cook over it. It's a great one for that first night when you get to the campsite, if you are going to cook something over a campfire to get it up and going real fast for you. The last thing that we're going to really touch on is you always want to make sure that you put your campfire out before you go in for the night or go off to go hiking or, you know, whatever it is you're going to do. Again, like I said before, the Paradise wildfires out in California were started from somebody leaving a campfire unattended. So you want to make sure that you put it out. A note on that, the best way to really put it out is to get a pail of water or a, you know, like a watering can that you'd use for flowers, and pour that over it slowly, and kind of take another piece of wood and mix everything around, stir everything up, get everything nice and coated. But you don't want to take like a bucket and dump it on there, because if you do that, what you're going to do is you're going to make your campfire site is going to be unusable. So if you want to light a fire off tomorrow, you know, to cook breakfast, or you know, in the next night to sit around, it's probably going to be very hard to light that fire off. So you want to make sure you coat everything, get everything good and wet and extinguished, but not so much that you can't light a fire later if you need to. And always, as like a rule of thumb, if there's any wood left in there, you want to make sure that you can kind of touch it. It's cool to the touch, anything like that. If you can't put your hand on it for more than a couple of seconds, it's probably still too hot. So, as always, you know, respect fire, just like we respect electricity. And that is about all I have for you guys. As always, like, comment, share, subscribe to the channel if you're not subscribed. And stay safe out there. We'll see you guys on the next one.